Do you run a gated community or residential estate? Are you tired of using traditional access control methods like placing phone calls, issuing visitors' pass, tags, or ID cards? Are you tired of having the privacy and security of your residence invaded by unwanted guests? Then you're in luck because things are about to change with the Gatehouse app. Gatehouse is the most efficient software for managing access control into gated communities and residential estates. Not only does Gatehouse control, manage, and secure access into estates, it is also a sophisticated estate CRM, customer relationship management tool, giving you a feature-rich application to manage your residents, their dependents, and buildings in the estate. Gatehouse is cloud-based, which means there will be no expensive hardware requirements or installation efforts. Gatehouse is easy to set up. Estates can start running within a day. Gatehouse can run on any device, be it a smartphone, a tablet, a laptop, etc. It comes with a mobile application available on both the Android and iOS platforms, and these can be installed from the various app store by searching for the application Gatehouse. It is based on matured QR code technology. It allows online payment for services through integration to a payment system. It allows integration to RFID NFC-based access control systems. Gatehouse can easily be accessed by logging onto the software with user or admin privileges, which will be provided by management as the case may be. How does it work, you ask? Let's find out. Click the icon for the app, a bookmark on your phone or desktop. Enter your username, which is usually your email, and input your password, then click Login. And voila, you're in. Once you're logged in, you will be taken to your dashboard. Note that the dashboard you get is related to your role. The different roles implemented in Gatehouse are Property Administrator, Resident, Dependents, and Staff. Thus, your dashboard may or may not have some features depending on what access you have been given. At the top is a welcome area showing who has logged on and the estate to which he belongs. Right below it are the following. Plan visitors, number of visitors you have booked in on that day. Visitor check-ins, those who have been allowed access into the estate already. Raised gate pass, the number of requests to take items out of the estate or take items out of the estate by third parties. Gate pass check-ins, those requests that have been actioned for that day. The drop-down menu on the left-hand side shows a navigable list of actions you can take, which include visitors, gate passes, my dependents, cart, transactions, services, notifications, and profile. To book a visitor, click on the Book a Visitor icon on the dashboard, or click on the visitors link in the drop-down menu on the left-hand side and select the plus sign in the right top corner. Proceed to fill in details on the screen. If the visitor has been booked before, the application saves the details of the visitor and you can click on Select Visitor. This action will preload the visitor's basic information on the booking screen. You can complete the form with the required information for that specific booking. Click Submit and a new visitor is booked. Really easy, right? You can view visitors by clicking on the visitors icon on the dashboard or clicking on the visitors link in the drop-down menu and selecting visitors. The booking tab shows details of all visitors you have booked. The visitors tab shows the list of your registered visitors and they are registered the first day you booked them in. The pending tab shows the pending request for booking approval by your dependents, or shows the booking that you are awaiting approval from your primary resident if you are a dependent. Use the range filter to see bookings for different days up to 1 month, forward or backward. And you can enter any text to search for a particular booking You can also right-click on the action button on the right of any visitor to edit the booking or cancel the booking. I know you must be wondering what next. What happens when I book in my friend Dukwe? How does she get in? Okay, easy peasy. Once you have completed the booking, a message will be sent to Dukwe's email or WhatsApp explaining that she has been booked into your estate, and the message will contain a QR code and a passcode for Dukwe's identification at the gate. On getting to the estate, Dukwe will only need to show the QR code to the gate official, who in turn scans it for approval. If Dukwe's credentials appear on the database, she is allowed access. If in any case Dukwe cannot access the QR code, she can give the passcode to the gate official, who in turn runs a simple query for admittance. Also, if Dukwe's device is temporarily or permanently unavailable, she only needs to give any relevant information, which can be her full name or your full name, to the gate official, who in turn runs a query for admittance. That's it. And Dukwe is allowed to proceed to your house, no calls, no registers, no pass, at almost no cost. Now, isn't that incredible? The gate pass model allows you as the resident to control movement of items in and out of your house by anyone. You can raise a gate pass to allow a third party to take things into the estate or remove things from the estate. Gate passes can be approved by the estate office as an option depending on the estate's policy. To raise a new gate pass, you can click on the Manage Gate Passes icon on the dashboard and select the plus sign in the top right corner, or click on the gate passes in the drop-down menu. Fill in the details on the screen and click Submit. A new gate pass is raised. The Gate Pass tab shows details of all gate passes you have raised. The Pending Gate Pass tab shows the pending requests for gate pass approval by your dependents and the gate passes you have raised that are pending approval from your primary resident if you are a dependent. The Dependents model helps you to manage everyone connected to you within the estate. The categories of people under the Dependents model include spouse, child, your own child or ward, domestic staff, staff who most likely work for you and live with you, business staff, staff who have to come in from outside the estate daily, and others. The Dependents model has only three features, which are visitors booking, gate pass model, and services model. Primary residents can view, add, or edit dependents by clicking on the Manage Dependents icon on the dashboard. There are two different access types for dependents. There is the limited access. Here, the dependent will not have access to the portal and cannot perform any service on the portal. Then the full access. Here, the dependent has access to the portal, can book visitors, and raise gate passes. Primary residents can track the activities of selected dependents on the portal. This means that tracked dependents' requests for visitors booking and gate passes will go to the resident for approval. This feature can be turned on and off from the Edit Dependents model. The Services model provides a way for residents to access services provided by the estate or by third parties. Services can be anything and is defined by the estate office based on the estate's office services and policies. When a resident requests for service, the application logs the services and provides a payment gateway, if implemented by the estate, that allows payment to be made online. Subscription for estate dues can be paid online too, if implemented by the estate. To open the model, click on the services icon on the dashboard or click on the services link in the drop-down menu. You will find a list of services available on the estate portal displayed by categories. Click on any service category, then select services requested. Follow on-screen instructions to complete your transaction. The notification link in the drop-down menu provides you with reminders, communication from other sources, or other timely information from the software. And the profile link shows all your personal information, including your phone number, house number, QR code, and passcode. You can also edit your profile by clicking the Edit tab. You can also access Gatehouse through its website. You would only need to input the URL gate-house.com in your browser and click on Login to your estate portal. Then enter your username and password, and it immediately takes you to your dashboard. The requirements for Gatehouse are very basic and cost-effective. Gatehouse would need to have a reasonable, stable, broadband internet access to be able to interact with the visitor's data on the server. In the back office, a desktop, laptop, tablet, or mobile phone with a web browser with access to broadband internet. At the entrance of your estate, your security officers need to have a tablet or laptop with minimum of one USB port and a QR code scanner with a suitable cable length about 1.5 meters or the wireless model. It is recommended that you have one set of scanner and tablet for managing entry traffic and another set for exit traffic. If you have a separate pedestrian access, you may also want to have one for managing pedestrian traffic. For any one entrance into the estate or community, it is recommended to have two gate officials with one set of scanner and tablets each for managing entry traffic and another set for exit traffic. If more than one gate entrance point, you may want to increase the number of equipped gate official. Gatehouse is safe, reliable, affordable, and easy to implement. Gatehouse is developed in the UK by Carl Phillips Limited. It is distributed and supported in Nigeria by C-Part Consulting Limited. For more information, visit gate-house.com or cpart-consulting.com. And remember, access and security controls are like a seatbelt. We use seatbelts so we can drive faster, more safely. We apply access controls so even when we take risks, we aren't at risk of exposure. Get Gatehouse today. You will be glad you did.